Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you to the Church of St. John the 23rd here in Tamaulipas, Pennsylvania, on this beautiful day as we celebrate this great gift, the gift that God gives to us in the sacrament of matrimony. Jim and Corey come to this place to declare their consent before us, but more importantly, before God. So we pray with them today, and we pray for them. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, all. Brothers and sisters, as we begin this celebration, we first acknowledge our sins, mindful that God loves us and cares for us, and so best to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to live a contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father, to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, when you created mankind, you willed that man and wife should be one. Bind James and Corey in the loving union of marriage and make their love fruitful so that they may be living witnesses to your divine love in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatness of spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a cymbal or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hang my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous. It is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord. Jesus
Please. Did you know that statistically there are about 2.1 million weddings that happen in the United States every year? Did you know that?
You didn't know that.
Did you know that? I went online and looked it up. Statistics. 2.1 million. Now let's divide that up. That's about 5,700 weddings every day. Right? I did the math. But since most weddings, well, traditionally take place on Saturdays, that means that there are probably about 40,000 weddings happening today. So this is just one of 40,000 weddings. You know, 40,000, that's a lot of weddings taking place today in the United States. So you might want to think, or might think, with so many brides and grooms, with, you know, so many tuxedo rentals and dresses and flowers and wedding cakes and all those kind of things that you have to get, it's just another wedding. What's the big deal, right? Wouldn't you think that way? Yeah, you shouldn't think that way. It's very far. But all of those things, even though they're important, are not what this day is about. And they're important. I would give you the suits, the dresses, and the beautiful wedding dress, and the nice flowers, and the decorations, and all the things that you do to make it look special. They're important. But at the very heart of this celebration is the basic belief that Jim and Corey are welcoming the power and presence of Jesus Christ into their relationship. No, it's no secret that we live in a time and an age when many are not entering into marriage. Many people just decide to live together. And we're obviously living in a world in a time when, for some odd reason, marriage is being redefined, as if it could be redefined. Yeah. And all of those things, as a result, keep Jesus and what his plan for our lives at bay. Keeps them at arm's length. We don't want you as a part of our relationship. But today, Jim, by virtue of the fact that you've chosen to be here in church, to have your wedding, as it were, your marriage, as it were, blessed, you're inviting him into your relationship. And at the core of this ceremony is the assurance that Jesus accepts your invitation. In the very same way that he was present at that wedding in that little town of Cana in Galilee all those years ago. You know, he saved a social faux pas. You know that, don't you? You know, not having enough wine. Or other adult type beverages, yes. I always like that gospel and think about six stone water jars, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Six times, let's say 25, is that 150 gallons? You got 150 gallons of wine to share today? That's a lot of wine, isn't it? Those people, they knew how to party, didn't they? Yes. You know that saying, choose company, freeze crap. this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church minister and this community that is gathered. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage and mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church, to the court, I ask you to state your intentions. Are you here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, I invite you now to declare your consent before God and his church. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. For God has joined them in your body. Lord, bless and consecrate James and Corey in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. To God, the Father Almighty, brothers and sisters, may every prayer of our heart be granted, for his will it is that all commandments should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
motion. Grant, we pray, that what we ask in faith, we may truly obtain through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh,
are to the holy order of all. May holy therefore these gifts we pray by sending down your spirit upon them like you do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles,
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Welcome to each other on the side. Thank you.
one heart in love, those who have already joined in this holy union and replenished with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. May you find happiness and satisfaction in your work. May daily problems never cause you undue anxiety, or the desire for earthly possessions dominate your lives. But may your heart's first desire be always the good things waiting for you in the life of heaven. May the Lord bless you with many happy years together, so that you may enjoy the rewards of a good life. And after you have served him loyally in his kingdom on earth, may he welcome you to his eternal kingdom. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. It's my joy to present to you Mr. and Mrs. James Kirk.